Thank you, Colin. First of all, I would like to congratulate all of you for getting through this program. I only have classes for 1 hour. Of course, in one day there are sometimes six classes, so it becomes 6 hours. But the break makes a difference. However, I'll make a couple of submissions to you in the spirit of which Karamat and his fellow Pakistani lawyer colleague spoke. One, it is commonplace for us to say that India is a democracy. Well, that's true. But as the Cambridge economist Joan Robinson said, everything you say about India is true, and the opposite is also true. So, for some time, the entire Indian elite was full of chauvinist anger at the fact that 5 soldiers were killed on the line of control in Kashmir. I think that politicians have a short memory, because a month before that, Pakistani soldiers had been killed on the line of control. Another way of going into chauvinism was saying that the Pakistanis had beheaded Indian soldiers. But Praveen Swamy, then with Hindu, and no doubt, he had said that the Pakistanis had given evidence that their soldiers had been beheaded. And this evidence they had given to UN Mogil, that is the UN force on Pakistan-India borders. And the reason they gave was, they were already pressed on their western flank, that is the Afghan flank. They did not want trouble on the eastern flank. There is also, if I may say so, a kind of diversionary theatrical statements. What is that? So that it is said that, oh, Pakistan is a threat. Now, I know a little arithmetic, so I'm a bit puzzled of how a country like India, which has an army of 1.3 million, 300,000 paramilitary forces, not to speak of specialized police forces like the Greyhounds in Andhra and so forth, I fail to see how this country can be a threat to Pakistan. But then, I think we should look at the link between social movements and Indian propaganda. All of us, Colin, Prashant and I, are worried about what will happen to the food bill. But knowing Professor Manmohan Singh and his agility at shifting positions, I would imagine that they'll consider the cash transfer. Especially now, because the rupee has plummeted, foreign capital is not coming in, inflation is high. In a word, the economy is in a mess. Some of us said that for the last 6 years, but the press was not willing to listen. Now, in one of the major media channels, CNN and IBN, 100 press people have been dismissed. So much for freedom of the press. But I would like to talk of some of our laws. For example, the Armed Forces Special Powers Act. Some of you may not know that it's not an Indian law. It was a British ordinance in 1942. At the time, we were having problems in the hills, later with the Mizos and the Nagas. And the Nagas, incidentally, had met with Gandhi, I mean, had sent him a letter, and Gandhi supported them but said, don't use violence. Armed Forces Special Powers Act, to sum it up, does 3 things. Number one, anything done or purported to have been done, that is claimed to have been done, under the Armed Forces Act is immune from prosecution without sanction from the Union government. Rape is immune, killing is immune, destruction of houses is immune. The reason I've raised this is a few days ago, lots of activists went to Kunan Poshpura in Kashmir, where there had been a mass rape by the army. A very distinguished journalist, D.G. Varghese, he went there, did a study, I don't know, 2 days, 3 days, and came to the flattering conclusion for the army that no rape had taken place. But I've been that side myself, and I can tell you that in that village, for 25 years there was no marriage because the women were considered things. The Jeevan Reddy Committee was set up to look at the Armed Forces Law. But they wanted to replace some parts of the Armed Forces Law with UAPA, Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. Now that would have been worse than the disease. So my submission to you lawyers is that one major battle that we will have to fight, including using laymen and semi-literate about law, is going to be to write our legal system. The last point I want to make is that the legal system is also used to cover up the excesses or the failures of what is called neoliberal economics. Now I know what liberal is, since I am a student of political theory. I know what economics is, but what is this neo? Is it really neoliberal? That's an American coinage. It's actually neoconservative. And what has happened? According to the Arjun Sengupta report, only 22% of our population was above the poverty line. 78% of the population had an income of 20 rupees or less and was below the poverty line. But that is not Manmohan Singh's line. So Manmohan Singh and his key advisor, ex-IMF, Montek Singh Ahluwalia, they have created new poverty lines. And now there's been such a tamasha in the Planning Commission that there are problems. Because food inflation is going at 15 to 20% for people. I don't know how much fish karamat and all eat, but certainly from Bangladesh they do eat fish. Well, you'll be surprised to know that fish in the more fashionable Delhi markets, that means they're more expensive, go up to 600 rupees a kilo for shrimp, and for katla 800 rupees and so forth. So the poor are starving. And I think if we have learned anything today together, it is that we must together fight this injustice. What is being done is against the Constitution. And by the way, against even elementary law. So for example, there was a Colgate scam in which the Prime Minister was hinted at. He, of course, being very swift of foot, he suddenly disappeared for a while. But now it has come out that there are hundreds of files and documents on the Colgate which are missing. And there is a special committee of the Supreme Court which oversees this. Yet, files are missing. So in a word, our country is in a mess. But I think as educated people, as activists, we overdid debt to our country and, by the way, to our neighbors. One, there should be an 11th commandment, thou shalt not fight thy neighbor. We must make this a more humane law-abiding, feminist, and reasonable kind of South Asia. A South Asia which is not such will be a danger not only to its neighbors, but to its own people. Seeing all of you here, I am reassured that even though I am growing old without the expected victories, that you are young enough to fight it out, you'll get our help, and change things for the better in your countries. I hope you had a nice seminar, and any time we can host you for a seminar, please don't hesitate to ask us. Thank you.